Elizabeth Lund, the Senior Vice President of Quality of Boeing Commercial Airplanes, or BCA, shared the company's plans to make its Boeing 737 MAX assembly line safer and more focused on quality. The information was shared at a media briefing at one of the company's sites. Interestingly, and unfortunately, Lund's statement on June 25th included statements that resulted in the National Transportation Safety Board, or NTSB, sanctioning Boeing for disclosing non-public information. In this video, let's take a deep dive into Boeing's plan, the information shared, and how it found itself in more hot water with the NTSB as a result. Lund began the media briefing by explaining the why of the Alaska Airlines flight AS-1282 incident on January 5th. Of course, very few people watching this video will need to be reminded that this involved a Boeing 737 MAX 9 losing its mid-cabin door plug while climbing out of Portland International Airport. The incident resulted in several injuries and the Boeing 737 MAX 9 being grounded for an extended period of time. Lund explained that the aircraft's fuselage came with 5 non-conforming exhibits from Spirit Aerosystems, including rivets located near the mid-cabin door plug. As a result of these non-conforming parts, technicians had to open the door plug to reach and replace these rivets. Lund added that the company believed the door plug was opened without proper paperwork, saying, "So we believe that was a non-compliance process at that point by having the plug opened without the correct documentation and paperwork." The Boeing executive continued by explaining that the door plug was closed by the so-called move crew, which closes all the openings on the aircraft, including the door plug in this case, to keep the aircraft safe while parked outside. The executive noted that while the move crew did not reinstall the retaining bolts of the door plug, it was not their job to do so, as they had relied on existing documentation. The executive said that because the door plug was snug, it was enough for the Boeing 737 MAX 9 to fly around 150 flight cycles without losing the part. It was also how the aircraft passed the manufacturer's flight test, a process that is mandatory for all new aircraft. "A defect entered our system from our supply chain. The defect traveled throughout our final assembly, and then there was a lack of compliance with our processes for using the correct documentation," Lund is quoted as saying. Lund also revisited the steps that Boeing has taken since the Alaska Airlines incident. The aircraft manufacturer added end-of-line inspections for critical systems, identifying these critical areas that could result in a potential accident. As such, Boeing put end-of-line instructions in place, with most of these actions being done before an aircraft's first flight. "The change applies to all aircraft programs, and the goal is to ensure that no aircraft with non-conformance items leaving Boeing's system would be delivered to customers." Furthermore, another point was clearing up the instructions, documentation, and processes related to door plugs. The last points involved the reduction of traveled work, processing findings from the in-service fleet inspections, and engaging with airlines on best practices. In case you were unaware, traveled work is a phrase that means fixing non-conforming items while the aircraft continues traveling through different stations on the factory floor. What followed was feedback from key stakeholders, including employees, airline customers, Federal Aviation Administration or FAA audits, internal audits, a safety review panel, and an independent assessment from retired U.S. Navy Admiral Kirkland Donald, hired as a special advisor to lead a comprehensive review of Boeing's quality management system for commercial airplanes. This has resulted in 4 categories of action: investments in workforce training, simplification of plans and processes, elimination of defects, and elevating safety and quality culture. You would think the big news from this media briefing would be all the important changes happening at Boeing. Of course, this is big news, but shortly after, another ordeal stole the spotlight. That's because the NTSB had to publicly scold Boeing for publicizing confidential information. During the question and answer session with the media, Lund explained that the NTSB was responsible for finding the employee who failed to fill out one piece of paperwork related to opening the door plug. She also said that the revelation that one employee's failure to document work would result in the incident shocked Boeing's management. On this, Lund said, "We do know and we believe that there was a lack of documentation of that paperwork. It has been well reported. We know that the plug was opened and the paperwork was not there." As noted by NPR, Lund later clarified that it could have been more than one employee and that exactly who it was is the responsibility of investigators at the NTSB to determine. Investigators at NTSB are angry about the confidential information that was shared. The government body stated, "We learned that on June 25, 2024, Lund gave a long-planned media briefing without the knowledge or consent of the NTSB, at which she released non-public information and made unsubstantiated speculations about the possible cause of the January 5th door plug blowout, which is directly at issue in the ongoing investigation. As Boeing is a party to the investigation, it's limited in what it's allowed to say publicly." Thus, the NTSB says that Boeing quote-unquote blatantly violated the agreement it had when it shared non-public investigative information that it was not authorized to release, offering, quote, "opinions and analysis on factors it suggested were causal to the accident," was another misstep by Boeing. The NTSB says Boeing has been party to many of these investigations over the years, and it should have known better. The NTSB also took issue with Boeing stating that investigators were trying to locate the individual responsible for the door plug work. The NTSB reiterated that it has been focused on finding the probable cause of the accident. Amid the public scolding, Boeing will retain its party status but will no longer have access to the investigative information that the NTSB will produce as it continues investigating the Alaska Airlines mid-air door plug blowout. The board said that it would subpoena the manufacturer to appear in two hearings on August 6th and August 7th. It gets even worse for Boeing when you realize that it had already done something similar against the wishes of the NTSB earlier this year, actually just a few weeks prior. The NTSB noted that Howard McKenzie, Boeing's chief engineer, made statements about a Southwest Airlines Boeing 737 MAX 8 Dutch roll incident in June 2024. McKenzie had stated that the incident was unrelated to design or manufacturing, despite the board still investigating it. The NTSB reiterated that it has not determined the probable cause or causes of the event. Addressing the two violations, the NTSB stated, "This is the second warning we have issued to Boeing in just this year regarding its flagrant violation of the NTSB rules. It is crucial that the investigation speaks with one voice, that of the NTSB, to prevent the release of inaccurate, misleading, unconfirmed, and out-of-context investigative information." Well, there's a lot to process in this video. What do you think of Boeing's solutions, as well as its disclosure of confidential information against the wishes of the NTSB? Let us know what you think by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.